when you come from a place like Chicago all your life, and everything is tall and refined, and to come out to a place like this is a shock. You gotta grow into it. As I came here, and I saw there is some beauty in some of these remote places. There's something that hits you visually in color or tone or value or texture that maybe it deserves to be painted or drawn. We never looked at landscapes. We never had it surrounding us. We had people surrounding us. And most of my life has been in the city, even my artwork. But once in a while, you get a chance to get out to places like this, and you really appreciate it because your soul needs this too. And I'm privileged to have grown into it. When you come to a place like Boise, and I think I'm the oldest one here, and you had to show that you were some sort of a worthy person because all these people around you were cowboys and farmers, logical people. When you walked into a room and somebody said, he's an artist, the women would grab their skirts and, you know, or clothes or blouses, and he's an artist. Lost soul. But life has been very lucky to me because even in the war, to be able to do editorial cartoons. That's a special field to do editorial cartoons. You know, I always did one head or one figure, but then all of a sudden, when I went into Lincoln Park, and this is this fella selling balloons. And so there was a chance to do several people. And it was fun, it was good. You know, some people are amazed at what you do. And to me, it's just like writing. Did I have talent? I still don't think I can. I need another 100 years. There's more into it than what's in the classroom. But usually, you know, you can sit down here and paint this little thing here, paint it like that. But there, sometimes you have to go beyond what's real by capturing the essence of it. You know, I can paint with my fingers, but I'm a little bit rougher and tougher than that. One of the best instructors I ever had was a fellow who studied under Charles Wilimowski. I had very rigid instructors, but then all of a sudden, for some reason or other, we were matching color like this and this like that. I went into a class where Charlie Wilimowski was there, and it opened up everything. It wasn't more rhythm, you know, and put it on. If it's too red, lighten it or darken it. I mean, we're matching it like chips. And there's a way also by painting and mixing it as you go. You know, you have to have the touch. There are times when I have mix a brush of paint, and it's so beautiful to put down. You just feel the moment when you're doing it. It's a beautiful expression. You can paint hard, soft, medium, vague, any which way. You're really composing. Just like in music, you're composing.